Hello there, MKJ here, and I have a question for you. Are you still thinking that niching down will make you lose clients? Or if you've decided that, yeah, you probably need to niche down, but you're not quite sure how or why or what it would look like? Well, listen up. I've got one thing that you can do right now that will help you understand and decide what kind of niche you need to focus on. Okay, so now, let's say you are a business owner, whether you have an agency or whether you have your own private entrepreneurial business, and you are trying to serve everyone with your business. That's basically like being a chef and presenting a very bland, simple meal that you're trying to attract anyone who might want to eat this meal. We're talking about, let's say, a ground beef as your protein, white rice, and corn. Right? That's your meal when you are not niching down because you're trying to hit everybody. So you're not really speaking to anyone in particular. Now that's a pretty boring meal and you're not going to attract very many people with that meal. That's like not niching down. That's the kind of chef you are for your business. So if you want to be an actual successful conversational chef, the first thing you need to do is think about, who am I making this meal for? Who am I serving in my business? And get very, very specific. Get very niched down. So for example, instead of that ground beef, white rice, and corn meal, choose, are you speaking to people who love Mexican food? Well then, you need to plate up a plate of fajitas. You need to know how spicy they want it. You need to know if they want guacamole or sour cream, or if they don't. You need to know if they want sauteed or amazing peppers and onions, if they don't want that, if they want cayenne, or if they want regular white pepper. You need to know those details in order to make the mouthwatering meal for your niche. And if you're not doing that, just remember, you're just serving up plain ground beef, white rice, and corn. Nobody wants that, my friends. Nobody wants that. So when you think you want to hit everybody, you're going to hit nobody. Does that make sense now? Do you get it? All right. So first thing you need to do if you want to niche down, if you finally agree with that now and you want to create a mouthwatering meal, you need to decide, who are you speaking to? And don't be afraid to speak their language and exclude the people who don't speak your language. So if you're gonna specifically cater to Mexican food, people who love Mexican food, then speak the language. If you're gonna speak specifically to people who love Indian food, then speak that language. If you're gonna speak to the all-American burger, then speak that language. And don't be afraid that you are going to exclude other people who don't like that. You will make more money and you will transform more lives, which is what we're all about, if you niche down. So number one, write down a group of types of niches that you know enough about that you can speak the language. Then start thinking about, what transformation do I need to create for that niche? What do I know about? What can I speak? How can I speak the language? And what transformation do they need? Start there. Make that list, and then we can start whittling down how you can speak to it and how you can determine if these people are your people and they can afford the thing that you have for them, the transformation you have for them. But the first thing before you get to that, you need to decide on a niche. What type of chef are you? Just write down a bunch of different niches that you're interested in, that you know enough about, and then start thinking about, can I speak the language for that niche? Can I create a mouthwatering meal for that particular niche? You got this, my friends. MKJ, signing off.